Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve the error could not find the correct provider above this main.widget. So let's get started. So the main reason why we are getting this error because we are trying to access a provider's value, or we are trying to initialize a provider or call any function by using that particular provider above the scope of that provider. So let me just now scroll down. So this is the spot where I am initializing my provider, change notifier provider, context, radio provider. But I am trying to initialize this particular provider beyond the scope of this. So I can only access this provider initialize this provider inside my app class. But here I am trying to initialize or access the provider inside the init state of main dot. Here you can see, right, the provider you are trying to read is in a different route. Providers are scoped. So the simplest solution for this issue is basically we can access the provider or initialize them inside this particular widget that we have added inside our provider. So we can just like cut this out, cut this provider dot thing, cut this, and just go inside your my app thing, my app class, and here you will be having an init state, right? So basically just have an init state, and inside this init state have a widget binding over here, and within that try initializing or like calling any functions present inside your provider. And basically you can access values like this. And another important thing is that this particular provider's value can be accessed only within the classes that are present inside the widget tree of my app. So let's suppose say that you are like calling another particular class inside my app as a component. You can access the provider's value only if that class is inside the widget of class my app. So in case if it is just totally like unlinked, they don't have any connection between my app and their particular class, you cannot access the provider's widget. So the reason is obvious: initialize the provider thing only inside the init state of your parent class. So here you can see, right, this is the parent class of our provider, and this is the scope. You can't like declare it above the scope of the provider. Try doing that, and these provider's values are only accessible to the class widgets that are child of the main class. In our case, our main provider class is my app, because that's the thing we are having over here. The main class is the class that are defined inside the change notifier provider. Or in case you can try having multi providers, that's also a better choice. So yeah, this is it guys. And yeah, now let me just now run it. I've just like cut that and put it inside my app thing, and these are not errors, these are just like warnings because of some libraries. And I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, CRUD operations. So subscribe me. Thanks for watching.